And the recipe will be good.
Be delicious, obviously.
Of course.
Obviously.
Yes, it's going to be what we're making today. Two different ones. One is a zuppa di ceci. Now, this is as easy a soup as you're ever going to make. I mean, literally 10 minutes.
Zuppa soup in Italian?
Zuppa soup. See? Okay. So, 10 minutes, right?
Nice.
That's it. 10 minutes. But get this. It costs you about $1 to make it.
Come on.
Wait a minute.
Honestly.
And one pot.
Look, this is easy.
One pot to wash?
One pot. That's all.
$1 to make and 10
minutes. We're going to take a little bit of rosemary.
Okay.
A little bit of olive oil, some garlic. Saute it up. Add garbanzo beans.
Okay.
Heat them up. You can put water in it. You could put vegetable stock. You could put chicken
question.
Stock.
Can we use canned?
Sure. Absolutely. Absolutely.
Should we?
Make it easy. Look, there's not a lot of difference. The only thing you got to remember is that canned, you don't want to overcook, right? Because it's already sort of soft.
Yes.
Okay.
Right? Yes.
Okay.
Same thing when we do the uccelletto right here, right? So we'll get to that one in a minute. But once it's in there, then you just let it cook a little bit in the water, in the broth. Immersion blender, or put it inside a food processor.
Okay, wait a minute. Go back through the steps again, and we will publish on our Facebook page. We'll put the recipe.
Or you can send me an email, Franco'sItaly@gmail.com. We'll
You're making it really simple for us.
Right.
Yeah,
we like
that.
Too simple.
So
too good to be true.
What we have here is the zuppa di ceci, right?
And you sauteed rosemary and
olive oil and garlic.
Okay.
Now we add the garbanzo beans, the ceci beans.
Okay.
Saute them a little bit.
Okay.
Okay.
Add your vegetable stock, chicken stock, water, whatever it happens to be. Boil it up a little bit. Give it about 10 minutes. That's it. Now take your immersion blender or pour the entire thing into your food processor.
Okay, and whir it up.
And whir it up. Now
that's
we want it to be a puree like this.
I look at that.
Salt, and that's it. Now, to finish it off, I put a little of the garbanzo beans on top. Here's your rosemary, a little bit of parmigiano. Forget about it. Finito.
Forget about it.
Can I taste it?
Yes, you can. Absolutely you can.
You know I'm always ready to eat.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to give you a little, too, if you want.
Please.
You want to taste first?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm ready.
Okay. Mm. Oh, yum.
Nuttiness of the garbanzo bean. You catch the... I like bringing out the herbs in the wintertime.
Plus, garbanzo beans are really nutritious.
They are.
They're a great source
good
of protein.
Simple stuff.
That's so good.
Now, this is the uccelletto. And it's uccelletto means in the style of birds.
Okay.
Looks like a bunch of little eggs.
It does
doesn't
look
it?
Like small birds.
So
it
we
really
add
does.
This in there. Now we can amp it up a little sort of American style by adding chicken to it or a little Italian sausage, some peppers, some zucchini. This entire dish is this hearty, you know, cold weather busting dish that
it's
you can
It's perfect
do.
For this time of year.
How
it
do,
really
how
is.
Do you,
it
yeah, because cold weather's coming. We heard that from Todd. How do you do? What are the steps to that one?
So, all'uccelletto, a little bit more. We want to do, again, garlic. Now, this is a sage-based dish. We're using rosemary in the zuppa di ceci. We're using sage in this one.
Okay.
So we have, a little bit of garlic, one fresh tomatoes, or you can use a tomato sauce. You can sort of cut corners on this.
Mm-hmm.
And you want to saute that up. Then you're going to add, just let it go a little bit and add your beans. Canned beans?
Yes, you can do canned beans.
Okay.
Cannellini beans.
You are reading our minds.
But here's the deal. White beans are white beans, all right? So you can use cannellini beans. Excuse me. Cannellini beans, but you can use white beans too.
Okay.
Great northern beans, whatever.
So, really?
Oh, sure.
Okay,
absolutely.
I've got some of those in my pantry.
Sure, absolutely.
Okay.
Now we're going to mix this all together and we'll let it cook a little bit.
Gotcha.
Let the sage infuse.
Yes.
Let them get the flavor of the sage in there, right? Now to amp it up. A little bit of Italian sausage, a little bit of chicken, some peppers, some zucchini, whatever you have.
Really
right?
amped it up.
Oh my goodness, yeah.
And
so here's what we got right here.
Okay, so have you sauteed that meat in another pan? Okay, and then you add it?
Right.
But you don't have to add it if you have vegetarians or whatever.
So we have this vegetarian version of it, right?
Yes.
Which in Tuscany, my friend Marie Navani, she's the one who showed me how to do this one here. And you can also add pasta to this.
No.
Yeah, sure. Now we have a pasta fagioli. Right, so it's a little bit more heartier dish.
You are really educating us this morning.
I'm going to teach everybody.
Yes, you are.
You don't think you're going to get any more of the soup, do you? Because
I already know that answer.
Yeah.
Yes.
So now I can't double dip, so I don't know I'm going to.
Right here.
This is absolutely.
This is why Franco's my boyfriend.
Yes.
He brings plenty of spoons.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
So this is a great northern bean, basically.
Well, this one is the cannellini bean. But
it's the same thing.
Interchangeable, right?
Mm. Mm.
You okay?
Mm-hmm.
You okay?
I took too big a bite.
She's in paradise again.
See, you can always tell by somebody's face. If they liked it, they're going to let you know. If they didn't like it,
it's
going to
be tell you.
It's delicious.
This is so
I just
good.
Took too big a bite, and I didn't want to talk with my mouth full.
Don't you worry about it.
Okay, Franco's Italy at gmail.com if you want more information on the recipe.
Yes, we'll send you all the recipes on this.
Cool. We'll put them on our Facebook page.
We did. Just grilled a little bit of Italian sausage on it, too. So that makes a little bit of a difference.
It's so good here.
You know, I like Italian sausage.
Let me give some to you right now, Mary Beth. That was a hint.
You know,
here we go.
If you don't ask,
I always
you don't
have
get.
To share, even if it's meant for me. Thank you very much, my friend.
Thank you. Always a pleasure to be with you. I appreciate
so good
you.
To have you. Yes.
And thanks for wearing the Alabama Crimson jacket.
Yes. Yeah. For our- even after a rough night. All right. Thank you, friend.